Alright, class, today we're going to be talking about making inferences. So, Colleen, would you do me a favor and read the definition up on the board?
Inferences are a combination of an observation that we make from our prior knowledge slash experience.
Good job! Now, I want you guys to notice I have two things underlined here, observation and prior knowledge. The reason for this is that we need both of them in order to make an inference. So, Noelle, can you tell me what are the two things that we need to make an inference?
We need observation and we need prior knowledge.
Good job! Yes, those are two things that we need. So, we're going to go ahead and put that into practice. So, again, Precious, what are the two things that we need?
Observation and prior knowledge.
Good job! Okay, so, first thing, observation. Let's go ahead and look at this image up on the board. What do we see? Go ahead, jump them up.
Pigs.
Where are the pigs? Alright, pigs in the house. What else do we see, Noelle?
We see a wolf flying from the slingshot.
Yeah, right. But is the wolf in, like, a normal-sized wolf, or what shape is he in?
He's round.
Yeah, is that normal for a wolf?
No.
Exactly. Good job. And then, lastly, what else do we see?
There's a text.
Uh-huh. What does it say?
It looks like the big bad wolf has been playing too many video games.
Exactly. So, we just observed what happened here. Now, do we have any prior experience or knowledge about video games?
Angry Birds.
You're on the right track. My inference would be that the big bad wolf has been playing Angry Birds. Now, Precious, can you tell me why did you say Angry Birds?
I made an inference because that's what Angry Birds looks like.
Exactly. Good job. Look at you. Up ahead. All right. So, now it's your turn. Let us observe this image. Now, Colleen, can you make an inference based on this image?
Costco sells really big toilet paper.
Costco sells really big toilet paper. So you used, what are the two things that you used in order to make this inference?
I see someone's been to Costco.
Okay.
And the really big toilet paper.
Good job. Exactly. Wow, you guys are on a roll today. Pun intended. Okay. So, one last thing. You right there?
Yeah, I'm fine.
All right. So, one last very important thing. Inferences are not guesses. Repeat after me. Inferences are not guesses. Colleen, are inferences guesses?
No.
Precious, are inferences guesses?
No.
Good job. Okay. Reason for this is because they're informed by strong textual evidence. Noah, what are they informed by?
Strong textual evidence.
Oh, look at y'all really paying attention. Thank you. Good job. All right. So, we just observed images and tried to make inferences from them. Now we're going to try to practice on a text. Noel, can you read the paragraph for me?
Tommy and Johnny were hot and sweaty as they sat outside the principal's office. Dirt smeared both of their faces. They could hear their teacher's voice as she gave Mr. Jones her account of what happened. Tommy sneered at Johnny, and Johnny returned with angry glare. As Miss Green left Mr. Jones's office, the boys hung their heads so they wouldn't have to look her in the eye.
Now, Precious, can you make an inference from this?
Yes.
What can you make of it?
The Tommy and Johnny children had a fight.
Mm-hmm. And anything else from that? How does the teacher feel?
Disappointed.
All right. So yes, the inference is that Tommy and Johnny have disappointed their teacher after having a fight. And what are the two things that we use to make an inference?
Observations.
And? Colleen, what's the other one?
Prior knowledge.
Good job. Yes, so we observed the dirt, the angry glare and the sneer, they hung their heads so they wouldn't have to look her in the eye. And we have prior knowledge on a student's respect for their teachers and the fact that we know about fights. So, last bit, we're going to do a cheer in order to remember. It goes to the tune of 1, 2, buckle my shoe. Now all together. 1, 2, steps for inferencing. 3, 4, read the text. 5, 6, note and observe. 7, 8, remember and connect. 9, 10, make an inference. Now this time, you guys are going to do it along, but also clap along, okay? And 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, steps for inferencing. 3, 4, read the text. 5, 6, note and observe. 7, 8, remember and connect. 9, 10, make an inference.
Oh, thank you.